of success on the new economy. And it's about sharing. It's about the sharing process. Even Sir Charles Brunson rents his island, and basically all the people that have their private jets, he then rented them. Why owning when you can rent? This was the the marketing phrase for the NetJets for several years. So we are talking about getting the same amount of products available, so you need half, you won't be needing half. I think at the limit you will reach half. But studies already showed us that car sharing can reduce almost immediately the number of cars by almost 28%. 28% in terms of environmental analysis, it's quite handy. It comes quite handy. You can see here that how the thing goes. It's not exponential, it's bloody quantitative. Because from almost zero in 9 years, you have a growth of almost eight times the number that you had before. And I think these numbers will continue growing as people, as it's like Uber. Uber began in Portland with 7 cars, how many years ago? 3 years ago. Today is basically, but for me, it's the only means of transportation. I refuse myself to go on taxis, but because of the people not willing to drive. I don't have anything against taxi drivers. I just think they are not polite enough, and I think the service that we feel on the Uber is definitely different than the service that you have on a regular car, on a regular taxi. So, and also the number of vehicles grew a lot, but as you see, not of course on the same percentage. It's almost basically the same thing. To prove it, how exponential quantity it goes, and the biggest issues to come around here was first this number I gave already, the 30% that can reduce circulation, or say the number of cars circulating on the streets, but also the challenges in the future, because I think we are on the ribs of a profound change on the way we transport ourselves.